Hey y'all. A lot of you might not know that April is Limb Loss and Limb Difference Awareness Month, so I thought I'd give you a little bit of statistics on who kind of compiles who's an amputee. So over half has to do with vascular disease, and this also includes diabetics for limb loss. The second one is about 40%, and it is all trauma, which means accidents and things that are unforeseen. And then less than 2% is actually from cancer. So I'm in a really rare subset of amputees. Another little factoid is that about 70% of people who have lower limb amputations are below the knee. I am an above the knee amputee, which means that I don't have a knee. It also is a lot harder to be an above the knee amputee than below the knee, and I think people who have had both can attest to that. It's just, you know, one less joint for you to be able to use to walk, and there's a lot more of the knee part that has to work, and walking, and everything is just a lot more complicated because you have to add that extra joint piece to it. And obviously, if you know me, then you know how I lost my leg. It was to cancer. And so if you see someone that is missing a limb, don't thank them for their service, please. It's really uncomfortable when it happens, and it just makes everything super awkward when you have to explain, like, that's not actually how I lost my leg. And while we're on that subject of approaching strangers that you don't know that have any type of disability, don't just walk up to them and say, "What happened?" Because it's really uncomfortable. Because basically you're assuming that they know what you're talking about, and then you're also asking them to possibly relive some sort of trauma that they may had. It's like, let me ask about the most personal thing in your whole entire life. It's just, don't do it. And I will leave you with one last little tip. If you really want to talk to someone and just have a conversation with them about their disability or anything like that, it's totally welcome if you approach it in the right way. And also read the room. If the person seems like they don't want to talk about it, just say, "Have a nice day." But you can go up to someone and say, "Hey, do you mind if I ask about your disability?" A lot of times that is way more welcome than just cold approaching someone. And then if your kids are curious, it's really great to just have your kid go up and ask themselves, because it gives the kids confidence, and it also helps open a dialogue for your kids to encounter someone that they would never necessarily meet on an everyday basis. And you will notice that I said disabled. Calling someone differently abled is actually a little condescending, and it's a little dismissive of the fact that we are disabled. We are at a handicap, if you will, kind of like in golf. So I think that it's best to just call it what it is and not try and change the name.